So, to go on and make your house or a slightly more advanced house we've looked at before, what you kind of need to think about to start with is the layout of the house. Okay, so in other words, all the different bits that poke out of the house, how would they look if you kind of saw them from a bird's eye view almost? So, for me, if I was doing my house, I would start with my garage, which is kind of probably sort of that sort of shape. And then the main part of the house, which the garage is actually attached to, is probably a similar shape but a little bit wider. Okay, so I've slightly done that wrong there. So I'm just going to undo that. And we'll just try drawing that again. There we go. Lovely. And probably about there. Okay, now if it's not wide enough, I can just select the shape, press that button, and then pull out a little bit more. Okay, and then finally, I've got a little bit out the back of my house here. Okay, actually, I'm looking at my house now, and I think this bit is actually wider. So I'm going to make that a little bit wider using the handle again. Okay, lovely. And see, it's worth using the orbit tool to go at the different sort of angles so you can see what's happening. And then I'm going to add the little extension bit out the back. Now you'll notice that I've done it, so we've got space in between each section of my house when in reality, actually, they're all joined together. Now, the reason to do this is sometimes if you join things together, they can get stuck on each other when you're using the push-pull tool. So, leaving a little gap means we can then bring them together later once we're happy with how everything looks. Okay, so start off by thinking about the design of your house and all of the different parts that come out of it, any extensions, garages, and so on, and draw them on as rectangles and shapes like that.